welcome to another of MATLAB Helpers lessons on stock market with MATLAB. So starting from this lesson, we'll look into how we can design an application that fetches live real-time stock market data into MATLAB and then uses some functions to plot the data. In this particular episode, what we'll look at is we'll try to find out where exactly the data is located in the Yahoo Finance website's paid source. So let's begin by typing in Yahoo Finance in the Google search tab, and we'll open the very first link over here. So since we're interested in only the data of particular stock companies, what we'll do is we'll just type in any stock company that comes to our mind, for instance Google, and we'll open the information for that stock company. So this will open another web page, and here you will see that we have the real-time data displayed in bold letters over here on the left-hand side of the screen. So since the US market is not open at the moment, this data is not varying. So what I'll do is I'll just open the stock the data of a stock company that is currently trading. So I'll just look for Reliance. Okay, so this is also closed, so I'll just Reliance Industries Limited. Yeah. Yep. So as you can see, the market is open, and this is the current stock price of Reliance.ns stock quote. So what we'll do next is we'll just look at the paid source of this web page. So I'm using Google Chrome here. You can also use Firefox or any other web browser that allows you to view paid sources. Now, as you can see, the paid source is quite extensive, and it's really difficult to find out where exactly the stock data is, the real-time stock data is. So what we'll do is we'll use a tool in Google as well as in Firefox that is called Inspect. So I'll just right-click and open Inspect the web page. So this will allow us to just move the cursor over these particular sections of the paid source, and we can see which line of code refers to which particular section of the web page. This way we can find out which lines actually help in displaying the current stock price. So I'll just browse through this code, and yeah, so before that I'll just unselect that stock price, and so this is the entire web page. I go below that. So yeah, so this is the place where the particular section containing the live stock price is displayed. I'll go further inside this. So we can enter inside a section by simply clicking on these arrows. So this again inside this further. So this is the point or the code where that corresponds to the real-time code. So as you can see, the code here or the syntax, the lines that actually display the real-time data starts with span class and then TRSDU and within brackets 0.3S. So what we'll do is we'll just look for this particular phrase and on the paid source and see if we can find it. Alright, so I'll just type, remember that we need to look for TRSDU and then bracket 0.3 seconds. So what I'll do is I'll just find TRDSU and 0.3. Yes. I have misspelled it, it's PSDU. Okay, so we have a lot of instances that correspond to the search, but if you just go through each line or each instance, you'll see that the correct instance is over here, right over here. So this particular line is the one we are looking for, and the value of 1328.90 as it has changed over time. So that is what corresponds to this particular livestock price. Now you notice that the price has changed from 0.90 to 0.80 as the pay source was opened a while ago. So the pay source actually contains the older price as well, but this particular web page contains the actual real-time price. So there's no issue in that. So we'll just remember that the actual data is contained after this particular phrase TRSDU0.3S, and also we'll remember that how to find the real-time stock data by using the inspect tool. Now that we have used and found out where the data is, we can simply export this entire page source in MATLAB and then use some functions to extract this line of code, and then use some more functions to extract only this particular numerical value, which is the real-time data. So this is how we can actually look up real-time data for a particular company on Yahoo Finance website, and that to the real-time data. Alright, so now we'll move on to understanding how we can look for other data, data such as, suppose if we also want to see the exchange rates for various currencies. So what we can do is we can look for, search for that thing in Yahoo Finance and type in again. Okay, so I guess I'll have to go back to the home page for this. Let's click on Yahoo Finance. And if you scroll down, here we have the list for cryptocurrencies, and following that we have the list for currencies. If I click on that, it should open a web page. Yeah, so this is the web link that takes us to the currencies web page on the Yahoo Finance website. Now here we have a table that contains the exchange rate for various currencies. So we have initially the rate for USD to INR, and then euros to INR, and so on and so forth. What we'll do is we'll again use the inspect tool here to find out where exactly or which line of code actually represents the starting and the ending of this table. So I'll just browse through this code, and so this is the entire page. If I go inside this, yes, so here we have the table. That's the foot, the header, and this is the table in actual. If I open it again, the inspect tool really makes it easy to find out where exactly the section of code we're looking for exists. That's the first row, I guess. Yeah. So now we have reached the point where the first or the header column is. If I go further down, in this section. This is what, this is the part of the code that contains the data, the currency exchange data. Now if I open this, now here TR represents the row, TD the data. So what we'll do is we'll look for the section TD in MATLAB, and we'll extract the entire row from that, and then from that row we'll extract this particular value. of 6987 for US to INR. So now that we know where exactly the data is, what we'll do is we'll just use this knowledge in MATLAB to fetch real time data for currency exchange rates. Similarly, we can look for real time stock market prices. So I can just scroll down further, and here we have the stocks, most active stocks, mutual funds, commodities. So suppose if you also want to display the changes in the prices of commodities such as gold and silver, we can go to commodities, and again you'll see that we have a table here. So we can again use the inspect tool and find out where exactly the data starts in the paid source. You will see that there is a very big similarity between the data of currencies as well as for commodities. They're both organized in tables, so we can expect them to be organized in a similar fashion. This is part, if I go inside this, so again we have TR representing the starting of the table row, and inside TR we'll have TD representing each data value in a particular row. Okay, since we are only interested in the price, so we'll just extract this particular data from the row as well as the name of the data, which is gold in this case. So this is how we can actually use the Yahoo Finance website and the inspect tool to look where exactly the data we want is located within the paid source. So I guess this is all clear, and I'll stop here for now. We'll continue our discussion on how we can actually design the application in AppDesigner and use functions to bring and fetch these data into AppDesigner and display them.